A very pleasant morning, children. So, as on Monday you are going to have your maths exam, I am making this video to help you out in order to get firm idea about your preparation for that maths exam. So, as you know, you have 3 chapters in total. So, the first one is chapter 3, HCF and LCM. So this is going to be a complete chapter, and next is chapter 8, simplification of numerical expressions. Okay, simplification. And then you have chapter 5, addition and subtraction of fractions. Addition and subtraction of fractions or fractional numbers, of which only the first two exercises, that is only 5.1 and 5.2. This is the syllabus that includes your upcoming examination. So regarding the same, I would like to give you how to prepare for each and individual chapter. So to start with, let us take HCF and LCM. HCF and LCM. Okay, just prepare only the textbook, children. Don't dig too much into other examples and all. Exercise problems and textbook points will be enough. Or in CW itself, I gave so many points pointing to what is HCF and what is LCM. Those points are enough. Exercise problems and notebook points. No need of reading all the textbook. Only for the examination sake, I'm saying this. So HCF means highest common factor. You know this. Highest common factor. And the other name for HCF, we call it GCD, which is greatest common divisor. Greatest common divisor. Okay. In the like sense, you all know that LCM is least common multiple. These full forms are quite important. Least common multiple. So let us see some useful things pointing to this HCF and LCM. So the first is LCM of 1 and any number. So in place of any number, if you put 4, okay, the LCM will be equal to 4 only. If you put 5, the LCM will be equal to 5. If you put 6, the LCM will be equal to 6. So the LCM of any number and 1 will always give us the same number. Okay, and in the like sense, HCF of 2 co-prime numbers is always 1. HCF of 2 co-prime numbers is always 1. Okay, for instance, if you take 5 and 9. Example 5 and 9. So if we try to find the HCF, for example, I am using long division method. So 5 times 1 gives us 5. The remainder is 4. As you know, in long division, the remainder will be the new divisor and the old divisor will come to dividend. 4 times 1 is again 4. Upon subtraction, you will get 1. This remainder will be the new divisor and the old divisor will come to dividend. So 1 times 4 gives us 4. The remainder is 0. By taking the divisor as 1, then only we got the remainder 0. So this 1 is going to be the HCF. You already know this. Okay. So for the co-prime numbers 5 and 9, the HCF is 1. all you need to keep in mind is this point. HCF of two co-prime numbers will always be equal to 1. Okay, the next is, you have variety of methods to find HCF, children. One is prime factorization and the other is, one is prime factorization and the other is short division method. Short division. And lastly, you have the method of finding HCF using long division. Okay. Focus on all the three models. Okay. For exercise, for each exercise, you practice 2 to 3 problems. Take randomly. For example, in that first problem, you have 1 to 9 problems. Then you take first one, fifth one, sixth one, okay, or seventh one, like that, and you practice. If you start practicing each and every problem now, it will take a lot of time. So practice randomly. Rest of the questions, you just check the HWs or CWs. Of these three methods, keep more focus on prime factorization method to find HCF, children, because it is one of the important ways to find the HCF. The others, you just go through the CW, but more practice you keep on prime factorization. I will show you an example on finding the HCF using prime factorization. So I want to find the HCF of 24 36 and 48. 24, 36 and 48. So in the method of prime factorization, what you will do? You will take individual given numbers like this, and the least number that divides 24 except 1 is 2 times. 2 times 12 gives us 24. The least table that divides 12 is again 2. 2 times 6 gives us 12. And again, 2 times 3 gives us 6. And lastly, 3 times 1 gives us 3. So whenever you see 1, that itself indicates that you are done with the prime factorization process. Next is 36. The least number that divides 36 is 2 table again. 2 times 18 gives us 36. And 2 times 9 gives us 18. 3 times 3 gives us 9. And lastly, 3 times 1 gives us 3. The last number is 48. Okay. 2 times 24 gives us 48. 2 times 12 gives us 24. 2 times 6 gives us 12. And 2 times 3 gives us 6. And 3 times 1 gives us 3. Now, if we write the prime factorization of each and individual number separately like this, product of all these factors, that means 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3, and 36 is 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3. Next is 48, so which is 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3. Okay, now in order to get the HCF of 24, 36 and 48, we will check for the common factors. Okay, that means it should be there in all the three numbers. If you take 2, it is there in all the three numbers. That means factorization of all the three contains 2. And here also you can see, 2. If we try to check for another 2, 2 is here, 2 is here, but it is not there, so you won't take it. And lastly, we can see 3. 3. So, from this set, we have to take only 1, 2. Don't take 1, 2, 3, 2s. And in the second set, we have 2, so that 2. And in this set, you have 3 as the common factor, so 3. Now, product of 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 3 is one. So the HCF of 24, 36 and 48 is 12. So this is the way how you have to calculate the HCF using prime factorization method. Okay, do practice more on prime factorization method problems. Rest of the things you just practice, just random questions 1, 2 like that. And the other thing which you have to practice from this chapter is finding LCM children. You already know this, but I would like to give one example. So LCM of 18, 30 and 48. 18, 30 and 40. So 18, 30, 48. First, we will check for a number which divides all the three given numbers. It is very sure that we can take two tables, so that 2 times 9 gives us 18, 2 times 15 gives us 30, and 2 times 24 gives us 48. It is not compulsory that all the three numbers should be divisible. You already know this. Minimum 2. Okay, minimum numbers to be divisible by a particular table is 2. And we can cancel all these three numbers in three table. So 3 times 3 gives us 9. And 3 times 5 gives us 15. And 3 times 8 gives us 24. From here on, there doesn't exist any table which divides 3, 5, 8. So we can take individually. 3 times 1 gives us 3. That 5 you drop as it is. 8 you can drop as it is. And 5. 1. 5 times 1 is 5. 8 you will drop as it is. Next is 8. 1, 1, 1. LCM is going to be the product of all these. LCM is equal to 2 times, 3 times, 3 times, 5 times, 8. Okay. So 6, 9, 18. Okay, 18 into 40, you will get 720 as the LCM. Okay. So this is the way how you will find the LCM of the given numbers, children. So most probably you can find this type of models. And apart from this, in HCF and LCM, we learned another concept, that is first number into second number, first number into second number will always be equal to HCF into LCM. HCF into LCM. So if you have two numbers and whenever they ask us to find the product of first number and the second number, first number into second number will always be equal to HCF into LCM. Okay, that means they will give some numbers. For example, they gave first number as 32 and second number as 48. And here they gave the HCF as 16. And they asked us what is the LCM going to be. Okay, they will give you. Find the LCM when two numbers are 32 and 40 and their HCF is 16. What you will do, as we want LCM, okay, this multiplication you will put as it is, 32 into 40, and you will divide it with 16. Okay, I told about cross cancellation that day. 16 times 1 and 16 times 3 gives us 48. The leftover is 32 into 3, which is equal to 96. 96 is the LCM for the given question. If you have any confusion, you can multiply these two and then you can multiply by 16. Any method you can follow and you will get the same answer. So these are the basic concepts which you have to revise for chapter 3, children. In the next video, I will discuss about chapter 8 and chapter 5.